السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب اشرح لي صدري. My brothers and sisters in Islam, this is your brother Isa Ibrahim Yunus. I'm the leader and the founder of Teacher IB Jihad Foundation. As usual, as we used to do, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessings and peace be upon every single one of you who is watching this particular video. Brothers and sisters in Islam, as you could see the video besides me, is very pathetic. That needs to be addressed. Teacher IB, it's not my wish. It's not my will. It's not something I like to always bring you people pathetic video, horrible videos, you know, all the time appealing for fun. But when it happens to be like that, I have no option other than to do as I could do. So my sisters and brothers in Iman, let's try our best to also assist our dear sister Alima, who resides in Kumasi area, a particular, you know, area called Wasi. I think besides Alpha Radio, that's what she told me. Wallahi, this woman is really suffering. She just gave birth to twins. She gave birth to twins, and unfortunately, right after giving birth, she became, how do you call it, unmovable. She can't move. She's now, crippled? You know, a whole lot of stuff. The husband has tried his best. The family has tried their best. But yet, it's to no avail. So we are appealing to the Muslims Ummah. My woman, you are modest. She just gave birth. The breast milk is not coming. The money to buy some lactogens for the baby too is a problem. So please, if you are watching this video, kindly let the video touch your heart. Please, kindly let this video touch your heart. Our sister Alima, she's just 36 years old now. Wallahi, she's really suffering. I remember when they called me. At that time, we were on our brother Adam Abuaka, you know, the one from Pristia, whom acid was poured on. And I told them I can't do anything to help them because I am on a project. You know, I'm someone's issue that we have to complete. Alhamdulillah, as in my previous video, I said I am done with Abaka's own. We had about $1,500, which is about 8,700 Ghana cedis. The surgery is being done. We are waiting for the sore to be okay. Alhamdulillah, we are done with Abaka's own, and we hope we also assist our sister here. The children are crying day in and day out. They don't have any food to eat. The breast milk is not coming because the sister herself is not able to just stand. No, after delivery, she just became crippled. Allahu Akbar. Very pathetic. Very pathetic. The husband has tried his best. They have sent her to hospitals upon hospitals. They have spent all the money they have on them, and yet their sickness is not ready to just vanish. You know, the sister is not, you know, ready to even get healed. So sisters and brothers, we appeal to you. We should try and help our sister as we used to do all the time. Any little amount is not small. Any little amount is not small. If you can't even help us, kindly share this video to your loved ones. Probably they may see this video and it may touch their heart so that they will help our sister here so that she may get something to feed the children. Twins, imagine. If those of us who has been giving birth to single, imagine when your wife gives birth. It's not easy. It's not easy. The husband has suffered a lot, yet the wife is still crying. The wife is almost crippled now. The leg is swollen and a whole lot of stuff. When you see her, you cry. I don't know whether it's because I'm showing the video to you, you don't feel it. But wallahi, when you see the woman, you will cry. So we should also do our best to assist Alima, whose husband is Shakir. They all reside in Ehia Wasi, besides after Alpha Radio. That's what they told me. But currently, Sister Alima is with her mother, who resides in Yalwa, Kumasi Yalwa, I think opposite Zura FM. That's what she told me, which is true. We can't come out with video like this to deceive the public. Please, as we did and help our brother Adam, $1,500 is not a token. It's not a small money. You did it. So how come this sister, that we have to buy some food stuff for her and also try to send her to the hospital? Probably the doctors may diagnose her and we see what the problem is all about, so that our la ilaha illallah will be correctly as we used to proclaim. Because Rasulullah Sallam said, none of you will truly become a believer unless and until we love for each other. Unless and until what we love ourselves, we will wish our sisters and brothers would also have gotten what we have gotten. So if this woman had been your wife or your sister, how would you feel? Imagine the husband, Brother Shakir, who resides in Ehwa as I'm speaking with you. How would he feel after the wife has delivered? Peaceful, alhamdulillah, all the children, the twins, they are alive. Yet, the wife is crippled. Yet, what the children will eat is a problem. Because the husband has borrowed and it's not easy. So my sisters and brothers in Iman, let's do our best to help our dear Alima so that we can also put a smile on her face as usual. May Allah bless every single one of you who has spent his or her time to watch this video and also will share this video. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.